After a few nights in the jungle of Brunei, I headed back to Sarawak and stopped in Miri, where I was welcomed by a Dutch expatriate family.
We are in Miri, and in Miri is the only charging station in the whole island of Borneo. I found it with the PlugShare app. So I wanted to have a look to see if I can charge my car. And it's located at the Nissan workshop. But yeah, Nissan has the Type 1 charger, so this is the Type 1. This one is slightly different than my car because I use the Type 2. So I cannot use this charging station. But at least it's nice to see that they have some kind of infrastructure, yeah? Have you ever seen an electric car in Borneo, Rob?
No, well, some hybrid cars.
Yeah.
But no, that's not fully electric cars.
Okay. Rob, can you tell me where we are standing now?
Yes, we are here in Miri at the Grand Old Lady on the Canada Hill. Here it was the first oil well from Shell, or from the company who was going to be Shell. They discovered the first oil and they made here the first oil well with the Grand Old Lady. That's the way they dig up the oil from the ground. It started in 1901 till 1972, and until it was finished. But still, you can, when you're walking around here, you can smell some oil out of the ground coming. So there's still some, but it's too less to have a big oil well on it.
Okay.
So or a rig. So yeah.
And how is it now? Is in Miri, is there still oil being?
Yeah, but
produced?
Only in the sea, and only offshore.
Okay.
So onshore there is no oil in fields here anymore, but it's only offshore.
I left Miri this morning and arrived near the Nia Caves. It's supposed to be a huge system of underground caves and quite beautiful. And my goal after this is to go to Bintulu. Altogether it's about 230 kilometers drive, so might make a night, not just make it, but the nice people at the caves, at the reception, they let me charge here. So I plugged my car in and it's charging now at the front desk. It's really nice from these people. Expected this will be about 3-hour walk altogether. So if I come back, I definitely have enough range to reach Bintulu.
The vast limestone caverns of 31 square kilometer Nia National Park are among Borneo's most famous and impressive natural attractions. While walking all the way into the Great Cave, different species of trees and plants with beautiful tropical rainforest are to be seen around you.
I'm entering the second part of the cave now. It's called the Painted Cave, for obvious reasons which you will see later. Behind me there's a huge stairs. I estimate it goes up about 50 meters. Into the darkness. I don't know if you can hear it now on the video, but my voice is echoing around the cave now. I think this is the biggest cave I ever saw in my life. So I'm pretty excited to go in now.
See, here there are all kinds of... they're not bats. Oh, there's some bats, but I think there's... I see their tails and they're just birds having nests here. There are a lot of them. And there's some bats hanging on the side. It's pretty cool. I'm now in the Painted Cave. And I don't know if this is a prehistoric. But 2014 doesn't seem so prehistoric. And the problem is seems that the battery of my torch is almost flat. And you just cannot see anything here. That was it. I have my phone with me. I hope this is it, but it's definitely not strong enough, of course. Come on, help me. Well, at least we got like 10 meter vision.
I
I just got out of the first cave and I thought it was the painted cave, but it is not even the painted cave yet. That's in 420 meters from this point. And apparently the painted cave is really the highlight of this trip. And I was amazed by how huge and long this trail to the caves already was. I'm also amazed by how beautiful it is here. It's insane. Wildlife is to be seen around too, such as lizards, butterflies and various kinds of birds flying just above you. If you are lucky, you may spot one or two hornbills. So this is the painted cave, and I expected obviously to find paintings, but they're not here. There are some excavations, and yeah, they dug up some burials here. They dug up burials, come on. After I visited the caves, I went to Bintulu, which seems quite a big city. And I had an offer here from a guy named Thomas. I contacted him yesterday. I said, can I still come by tomorrow? He said, yeah, sure, but I'm busy and I didn't know exactly what his story was, but he wanted to put me in a hotel. So yeah, I'm arrived here in a hotel now. And he did have time to take me out for dinner, and I believe he's waiting downstairs now, so I'm gonna talk with him now.
Well, I saw you're driving in you're asking for help, so no problem. Since I'm around here.
We moved the car to Thomas' house because at the hotel we couldn't charge it. So we plugged it into this socket. It's now about 9 p.m.
Yep.
So then tomorrow morning can pick it up and then it's fully charged. Alright, this morning I left Bintulu. Yesterday I didn't make a move because I had the luxurious position to stay inside of the hotel, and I've been working on the movie, which I hopefully you have seen before this one.
And you needed a good timing to meet me on the road.
That's right.
Sasha Grabo.
Sasha, yeah, so this morning I started driving and I saw this guy next to the road and he was with his thumb, and it's really strange because I don't see that so much in a year and a half that I've been traveling. I only saw like 3 hitchhikers, so I was happy to finally see another one.
That's on the one side almost hard to believe, but on the other side it makes sense. Hitchhiking doesn't seem to be the preferred style anymore of the young kids, I don't know, but yeah. I still believe it's the most interesting way to travel.
So, but anyway, what about you? Where do you come from? Where are you going to? What have you seen?
I started this trip 3 of July, mm-hmm. after frantically tipping the last improvements and re-editions of my book Traveling 30 Years Around the Planet.
30 years, yeah?
Yes, and that's how long it took me to get to every one of those 193 UN countries. And then
so all of the 193 countries in the world you visited at least once?
Yes.
Insane.
I've just counted, I was I think 12 times in Malaysia, so...
Sasha! I believe you're a fucking legend, so it was an honor to travel with you. And
hey, great meeting you.
Nice to meet you too, mate.
And all the best for your project.
All the best. Where you?
I love it.
Where are you trying to get to today?
No idea.
No?
I like to hitchhike at night, but in some countries, like in Vietnam, actually hitchhiking at night was easier than during the day.
Oh.
But I don't think this is one of the places. Why do I like hitchhiking at night? Because it's a little bit cooler.
Yeah.
And probably get the long rides.
Yeah.
And then you don't have to worry about where to sleep, right?
Yeah, okay.
I'm on my way to Pontianak.
Okay.
It's another 700 kilometers, so I'm maybe 1 or 2 days, I hope.
Then you're on the equator?
Is it there?
Yeah, there's the monument. That's exactly on the equator.
Really?
There.
Really? Okay.
So I'm going to be there in 2 weeks.
I shouldn't
miss
it.
So if you're stuck there, then we can meet up there.
Hey, all the best.
Okay.
I see you somewhere around this planet, yeah?
Yeah, mate. Take care. All right.
Bye.
Bye, mister. There you go. and hitchhiking again. What a legend. Unbelievable. Oh, yo, ciao Sasha.
I arrived in Cebu, and for today I didn't really had an exact plan, so it was kind of range excitement again. I had my next offer is 260 km from where I left today, so I was hoping that maybe with a flat road I could get close to there. I came quite far, 217 km, and I have just 4% battery left. Today a lot of hills going up, going down, and had some extra weight, which reduced the range. Not really reduced, because 217 it's quite a good, it's really good for this electric car. It's a 2009 electric car, and more than 200 km, it's quite good. So somebody tipped me that there is a hotel here, they might have a charger for electric cars. So then I could even make it to my next host. So I'm now at a parking, I didn't see a charger, so I'm going inside to ask if they maybe have a charger inside or something.
It's a few hours later now. At the hotel they didn't have a charging station, so I went looking around and I found this Toyota dealer, and I thought small chance, because you know, you have the Toyota Prius, they mostly don't have a charger, but I thought I'd give it a go. They didn't have original charger obviously, but yeah, they let me plug in the car into their office, and yeah, it's Saturday, so they're already gone, but the guards are here and said yeah, you can use it as long as you want. So that's really sweet of them. The time is now around 7 p.m. I believe, and it's 60 kilometers to the next host, which is a hotel. It's the owner of a hotel who offered me a place to stay. I've been driving for about an hour, and the range dropped pretty quickly because it was still a bit going up. I only have 12% left and I need to do another about 30 kilometers. So to be sure I stop somewhere at the earliest convenience. And there are these people in this nice house. I approached them, said can I charge here? And one of the guys is now bringing me to his office, to where I can plug it in. That's nice, huh?
You want to drive?
This is the office of these guys. It's a Mart supermarket, I think. And yeah, inside we connected it. And now we're charging. And it's always so interesting to see how interested people are in electric cars.
Ah, there is
one.
Yeah.
Get on here. Okay, battery.
Do you know what is the top speed of this car?
Top speed?
Yeah, maximum speed.
How many kilometers per jam?
What do you think? You think fast or slow?
I think it's slow.
Slow?
How many?
260.
You can drive 260 per hour.
Yes.
Again, you balik. More again, you balik.
See, this is a typical Malaysian thing. They just say, we're not gonna leave you alone, we're gonna take you to small restaurant, offer you some food and a nice beer. That's really nice. Sweet guys. Thanks a lot. I was walking back to the car and then this nice guy from the restaurant came after me. And what do you want to offer me, mate?
Oh, no English, yeah.
So he wants to offer me a whole tray of 100 plus. It's an energy drink and it's actually my favorite drink in Malaysia. It's really good and it's a lot. So thanks a lot, mate. I'm really happy with this. Guys, I really want to thank you a lot. You, I just dropped by and you helped me, and you once again proved how kind humans are, how nice people can be.
Yeah, it's okay.
So I'm very thankful to all of you.
Yes.
And take care, all the best.
Yes.
I arrived at the hotel and with 11% battery left. And I think this is the, I'm pretty sure this is the hotel because I put it in the direction.
Hi.
Hi.
Steven.
Are you my hero?
Yeah. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
You drive fast. I was chasing after you.
Really?
Yes.
Were you behind me?
I was driving up and then I saw your car. I turned back. You are fast.
Yeah. It's an electric car. Super fast.
Oh, my friend, Mr. Lee.
Hi, Mr. Lee.
Hi.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Come on, come. You put the bag first. You want to take? You have you bath yet?
A bath?
Have you take a bath?
Oh yeah.
Already?
Oh no, not yet. No.
We go to take a bath first.
Yeah.
Then we go down and eat the local food.
I already just had dinner in
Minango.
Yeah.
No, we go to eat something.
Okay.
See.
Okay.
Eat the pork and.
We already plugged in the car.
Yep.
From the office, from the reception.
Oh,
we plugged it in here. And we're leaving it here to charge.
Yeah, no problem.
And tell me about what plan you have with me tomorrow morning.
Oh, tomorrow morning we are having a health screening mission at the central market. Then we are inviting you to participate in our social responsibility. So we are giving the high blood pressure testing, cholesterol testing, and the BMI and the height to give to the ordinary people,
okay,
to the local folks. So yeah, we will be inviting you to be part of us in the Rotary International Club.
Stephen introduced me to local food and called it a day as we needed to wake up at 5 a.m. for the volunteering work. More about that in the next movie. If you have enjoyed this episode, I will be very happy if you hit that subscribe button, or you can also leave a comment below for some moral support or advice.